There is no woodland animal as thought-provoking as the bear with very little brain, Winnie the Pooh. He's kind, he's clueless, he's stuffed with fluff, and he has a very concerning honey addiction. Winnie the Pooh's voice actor is a Disney veteran, as well as an amazing film, television, radio, Broadway, and commercial actor. But who could have brought such a memorable voice to this silly old bear? Let's find out. Before we start, don't forget to check out our Patreon, our Discord, and of course, like and subscribe. Sterling Holloway was born in 1905 in Cedartown, Georgia. He graduated from Georgia Military Academy in 1920, but left his native Georgia at age 15 to study acting in New York City. A concrete jungle where dreams are made, some say. He enrolled at the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, where he became serious about acting after a performance that gave him the sweet, sweet taste of applause. He soon was playing comic juveniles on stage in East and West. Holloway later joined the Theater Guild in New York, appearing in several revues before landing a pivotal role in the first Broadway production of songwriters Roger and Hart, David Garrick's Garrick Gaieties. He would star in four editions, introducing the Rogers Hart standard I'll Take Manhattan in 1925. And in the 1926 version, he introduced the hit Mountain Greenery. Assured of his success, he traveled west again to act in Hollywood. Holloway made his picture debut in 1926 in two real silent film comedies entitled The Fighting Kangaroo, followed by a role in Casey at the Bat for Paramount. Unfortunately, the higher-ups at Paramount didn't like his looks, deeming his face too grotesque for Hollywood fare. Gosh, that's mean. So he returned to New York and became a steady hit in revues and vaudeville. He joined the Pasadena Playhouse, a well-known venue for actors who strive to make the move to motion pictures. Agents and producers often frequented the Playhouse, and he soon received a call from director Frank Capra. Capra invited Holloway to take a role in his film American Madness, and shortly after, Holloway appeared in Von Sternberg's Blonde Venus with Marilyn Dietrich.
I'm through. Just cover me with leaves and tell my mother I died with her name on my lips.
Time out while we watch Joe die.
Is anyone around here human enough to give me a cigarette?
Here you are.
And you're the guy who said this was going to be a pleasure trip.
I think the first talkie I ever did was with Marlena Dietrich. It was called The Blonde Venus, and I wrote to my mother that I was being in a picture called The Blonde Venus, and she thought I was going to be the star.
It turned out Marlena Dietrich.
He would appear in an impressive 21 films throughout 1933, his most memorable role as the frog in Paramount's Alice in Wonderland, which also featured my man crush Mondays, Cary Grant and Gary Cooper.
There's no sort of use in your knocking.
Please, sir, how am I to get in?
I shall sit here till tomorrow.
I'm sorry you were hit, but how am I to get in?
I shall sit here for days and days.
As well as his first serious role in Hell Below.
In a picture called Hell Below. That was at MGM. And I did, if I must say so myself, and forgive me, Stanley, I did a beautiful dying scene. Uh-huh. Oh, I died beautifully in it. But that's the one that they were in.
Yet from 1934 through the late 1940s, his image and voice allowed Hollywood to consistently cast Holloway in films with stereotypical roles as Soda Jerk or Messenger Boy. Meanwhile at Disney, Walt had been tracking Sterling's vocal work as early as 1934, when the producer was first developing Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. Not in a creepy way, but like in a cool admirer way. Which is a really important distinction. According to a memo dated August 9th, 1934, Disney suggested Holloway as the voice of Sleepy. Although he didn't get that part, Holloway would make his debut for Disney in 1941, voicing the messenger stork in Dumbo.
Jumbo Jr. Happy birthday, dear Jumbo Jr. Happy birthday to...
He followed this up with a performance in Bambi as Adult Flower.
Hi, fellas. Flower!
Yeah.
In 1942, this thing called World War II happened, and Holloway enlisted in the United States Army at the age of 37 and was assigned to the Special Services. He helped develop a show called Hey Rookie, which ran for 9 months and raised $350,000 for the Army Relief Fund. In 1945, Holloway played the role of a medic assigned to an infantry platoon in the critically acclaimed film A Walk in the Sun.
Honey of a show on that beach. A honey of a show.
Meanwhile, Holloway's uncanny ability to express mood and emotion intertwined with his ear-pleasing voice made Holloway the perfect candidate as a narrator. His first chore as a narrator was as Professor Holloway, recounting the story of Pablo the cold-blooded penguin in The Three Caballeros.
Two things you will find most of down here are ice and penguins. It's amazing that anybody would want to live here, but most penguins wouldn't live anywhere else. You couldn't find better weather for fishing, skiing, tobogganing, or swimming. And there is nothing the average penguin likes better than a day at the beach.
His effectiveness as a narrator led Walt Disney to suggest that he be used for Prokofiev's Peter and the Wolf in Make Mine Music.
And this is Sasha, the little bird we told you about. Excitable little chap, isn't he? Forgetful, too.
As well as a narrator in Mickey and the Beanstalk.
The voice of the golden harp was so happy, it made everybody happy. And that's why they called it Happy Valley. But then, one day, a dark and sinister shadow crept toward the castle.
Also in 1946 and 1947, Holloway played the comic sidekick in 5 Gene Autry Westerns.
The only contract I ever signed was one with Fox, I think it was, to do 6 Will Rogers pictures. Just to be in those pictures with him.
Granddad, granddad, back in the good old days.
He raised 21 boys, but great-grandson has a terrible time with one.
Time staggers on, things have changed, Redskins gone.
They're moose.
Everything is different nowadays.
Exceedingly different.
Today my grandma bobbed her hair, went to the beach for a suntan. She no longer looks like an old lady.
She looks like an old man.
In 1951, Holloway turned out a deranged performance as the Cheshire Cat in Alice in Wonderland. The feline's cool madness is definitely one of the movie's high points, mostly because of Holloway's crazed delivery.
Also because he's just so fluffy, look at him.
Did you expect the white rabbit, perchance?
Oh, no, no, no. I'm through with rabbits. I want to go home. But I can't find my way.
Naturally, that's because you have no way. Always here, you see, are the queen's ways.
But I've never met any queen.
You haven't. You haven't. Oh, but you must. She'll be mad about you. Simply mad. On the warmest autograph.
Please, please. How can I find her?
Well, some go this way. Some go that way. But as for me, myself, personally, I prefer the short cut.
Oh!
And Holloway wasn't finished lending his voice talent to Disney productions. He also narrated The Little House, Lambert the Sheepish Lion, Goliath the Second, and Susie the Little Blue Coop.
They stripped her fenders, chopped her top, shackled her down, and hopped her up. She felt 50,000 miles younger. It was a miracle. That's what it was. And it couldn't have happened to a nicer little car.
Around this time, Holloway made guest appearances, as well as reoccurring roles in many television shows, including Adventures of Superman, Red Skelton Hour, The Life of Riley, Adventures of Rin Tin Tin, The Real McCoys, and The Andy Griffith Show. In 1964, Sterling starred alongside Paul Ford in The Baileys of Balboa, which only lasted one season.
Sometimes I just get steamed up about nothing, you know? I'm hot-headed.
Yeah, I know. Your mother was the same way.
I just hate to think of them over there all upset.
Well, you should have done this a long time ago, Jim. Believe you me.
Yeah.
After all, he is my father.
Yeah. And that's just the point, too. He takes you. He's got to learn that you do a darn good job around here, and every now and then you'd like to be told about it.
What do you think he'll do?
Well, see, he's had a chance to think about it, he slept on it, and he knows he's wrong, and... Come on, let's have breakfast. Forget about it for a while.
He even appeared in Gilligan's Island and the Twilight Zone episode, What's in the Box?
It's a racket, that's what it is. A penny ante Costa Nostra. So save yourself a headache, see? I ain't swinging for no big bills.
In that case, the set's ready.
What?
It's ready. And this time it's on me. Free.
Hey, wait a minute.
Well, you can't win them all.
Holloway's most embracing and endearing work for Disney was the sprightly, huggable, bear of very little brain, Winnie the Pooh. His vocal incantations captured the whimsy A.A. Milne intended for his classic reads, performing a sweet and innocent sing-song voice.
I am stout round, and I have found speaking poundage-wise. I improve my appetite when I exercise. Oh, stuff and fluff.
Three Winnie the Pooh featurettes, Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Tree, Winnie the Pooh and the Blustery Day, and Winnie the Pooh and Tigger 2, were done for Disney Studios and later combined for 1977's feature-length The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. Winnie the Pooh and the Blustery Day garnered an Academy Award for its animation, and the legacy of Winnie the Pooh still survives today. In fact, Winnie the Pooh became Holloway's most favorite of his Disney vocal roles, because Pooh showcased his greatest asset, his true acting ability.
To be in the same recording studio with Sterling Holloway was a great treat. I mean, the man was a consummate artist. I used to watch the way he performed. He used to underplay his lines. He would do them so softly and so easily.
Oh, hello. Am I glad to see you? It's more friendly with two.
Sterling Holloway was just, well, I was going to say he was a teddy bear. He was like Pooh. He was the human version of Pooh.
What sort of lunch is in that lunchbox?
Let's see here. Oh, summer squash. Yeah, salmon salad, succotash, spice custard, and honey.
Honey?
Honey? Oh, no!
Could you spare a small schmackerel?
Say, you ought to do something about that speech impediment, sonny.
Oh, thank you, Gopher.
Holloway also takes much of the credit for making Ka in The Jungle Book such a curious and disturbing Disney villain.
Walt came to me, and he was such a stickler for voices. He said, when you finished what you're doing today on Winnie the Pooh, he said, fiddle around and see what you can do with a snake. He said, I can't get the right voice. So I thought, wouldn't it be funny to have a snake with an aching back, because it would be such a long ache.
As Disney historian Jim Fanning once observed, Holloway not only delivered the lines with a mixture of menace and misplaced self-confidence, but also ad-libbed dialogue that sparked the imagination of the artists. Walt Disney was so impressed that he commissioned that Ka be brought back later in the film for a war of words with Shere Khan.
I was just curling up for my siesta.
But you were singing to someone. Who is it, Ka?
No. Well, I was just singing to myself.
In 1970, Holloway played the creme de la creme a la Edgar-loving mouse Roquefort in The Aristocats.
Come on, Roquefort, have some.
Oh, thank you. Don't mind if I do. Just a few dunks. Ooh, very good. My compliments to the chef.
This is yummy.
Delicious. Double delicious. This calls for another cracker. I'll be right back.
Holloway did commercial voiceovers for Purina Puppy Chow dog food and sang their familiar jingle.
Puppy Chow for a full year, till he's full grown.
He also provided the voice for Woodsy Owl in several 1970s and 1980s United States Forest Service commercials.
I'm Woodsy Owl, and I'm here to tell you about a dirty word, pollution.
Help Woodsy spread the word. Never be a dirty bird.
Hoo-hoo! Don't paint or write off buildings. That's pollution.
Give a hoot. Don't pollute. Never be a dirty bird.
Hoo-hoo!
Turn your radio down. That's noise pollution.
In the city or in the woods, help keep America looking good.
That really is so many commercials. He's like the Flo from Progressive of an earlier generation. Sterling Holloway passed away on November 22, 1992, but not before he was honored on October 22, 1991 with the first Disney Legend Award in the voice acting category. Holloway was an absolute legend with an incredibly sweet voice. Although he never changed his voice between characters, each performance was unique and fit the character perfectly. This is due to his amazing acting ability and his dedication to developing a personality. His performances have touched so many hearts and inspired so many people. I'm sure his legacy will live on through the films he helped create. And that you can trust.
Trust in me. Just in me. Shut your eyes. Trust in me. Hold still, please.
Thank you to these people for your generous support, and a special thank you to John David. You guys are really helping keep this channel afloat. Thank you. Thank you for watching this episode of Discographies. Don't forget to check out our Patreon and Discord, and click the thumbs up button below if you liked the video. And if you want to be notified when the next episode comes out, subscribe and click the bell. Comment below with characters you would like to see us cover. Further reading and references are linked below. We hope to see you in another Discographies.